Students, welcome to the new session of the complex variables, and in this session we shall be discussing about the analytic functions. What are analytic functions? What are the various conditions that are necessary for the function to be analytic functions? Which conditions are sufficient for the function to be an analytic function? And also we shall be discussing some numericals which will prove that a function is an analytic function or not an analytic function. So, analytic function. So, as the name suggests, analytic function. So, analytic function is also named by many other names. It is called by many other names. So, the names, or it is defined as, or it is said as holomorphic. It is also called as regular function, it is called as monogenic function, or it is also referred to as analytic functions. So analytic function is basically a function when we deal with the differentiability of the function. So the function is called differential when it is a single valued function for a particular point. But if we consider a particular area, or we consider a region or a space, and in this region or a space, at all the points in this region, if we calculate the differentiability of a function, and if in this region the function is differential at all the points in this region, we say that the function is differentiable, the function is analytic function, it will be called as holomorphic, it will be called as regular monogenic function. So this is the basic definition of the analytic function. So if f of z is differentiable not only at the z naught point but at every point of the neighborhood of z naught, then f of z is analytic at a point z naught. So this is the definition of the analytic function, that we are not checking the differentiability at this very point z naught, but we are checking the differentiability at each neighborhood point of the z naught. And if it is differentiable at each neighborhood point of the z naught, then such a function will be called as the analytic function. So a function fz which is analytic everywhere for all z in the complex plane, it is also called as the entire function. So we can say that an entire function is analytic, entire function is differentiable, entire function is continuous function. So an analytic function is a function which is differentiable and it is continuous also. A differentiable function is a continuous function. So the entire is having all the three properties. It is analytic, it is differential, it is continuous. But we cannot say that a function which is differentiable and continuous is also analytic. The function which is continuous is also differentiable. So a function which is analytic, differentiable, and continuous, it will be an entire function. So the chart is flowing in one direction, that an entire will be analytic, it will be differentiable, and it will be continuous. But the converse is not true for the analytic, for the differentiable, or for the entire function. So we have to keep it in mind that the entire function is analytic, differential, and continuous. But if it is analytic, it is differential, it is continuous, it is not necessary that it will be an entire function. So the converse is not true. So the examples of the entire function are that a polynomial rational function is an entire function. So the point at which the function is not differentiable, that z value at which the function is not differentiable, means the value at which the function is tending to infinity or it is leading an infinite result, that z point is called the singularity point. So if we have a certain singularity point, means that the function is not differential, it is not analytic function. So let us now discuss the various conditions for the f of z to be analytic. So in this we shall be discussing about the conditions which are necessary conditions for proving that the fz is analytic, and the sufficient condition for fz to be analytic. So the theorem states that the statement of the necessary condition for the fz to be analytic is that that the necessary condition for fz, which is equal to u plus analytic at all the points in R, will be that the equations delta u by delta x will be equal to delta v by delta y, and similarly delta u by delta y will be equal to minus of delta v by delta x. So these two equations are known as the CR equations. So if this CR equations or the Cauchy-Riemann equations are existing or these are equal to each other, then we say that the function f of z, which is equal to u plus iota v, will be analytic at all the points in a given region R, and provided that all these partial differentials, that is delta u by delta x, delta v by delta y, delta u by delta y, and the delta v by delta x, should all be existing. So this is a necessary condition for f of z to be analytic, that the CR equations should be valid, they should be satisfied, as well as the partial differential should be existing. So let us see at the proof of the necessary condition. So we know that if f of z be an analytic function in a region R, where f of z is given by u plus iota v, and we know that u is a function of x, y, where also v is a function of x and y. Now what we do, we take small differential because we have to calculate the differential. So we want to calculate f dash z. So we have to make an increment in z, that is z plus dz. So a small increment in z will definitely lead to an increment in u and v also. So we say that let delta u and delta v are the small increments of u and v, which is corresponding to the small increment delta x and delta y of x and y. So f of z plus delta z is equal to u plus delta u plus iota v plus delta v. So now substituting the values of f of z plus delta z and f of z, we have the equation as f of z plus delta z minus fz upon delta z. So we get the equation as u plus delta u plus iota v plus delta v minus of u plus iota v upon delta z. So you can see here that this u and iota v gets cancelled. So this iota v and this u get cancelled, and we are left out with delta u and delta v. So we get, if we take the limit of delta z tending to 0, we get the limit as limit delta z tending to 0 delta u by delta z plus iota delta v by delta z, which is equal to f dash z. And here this delta z can approach to 0 along any path. So we will again check the differentiability at different paths. And if the value of the differential is same for all the paths, then we will say that the differential is existing. And using this property, we will be able to derive the CR equations or the Cauchy-Riemann equations. So now we consider the case that the delta z is tending to 0 along the real axis, that is the x-axis. So P is of a fixed point and the Q is a neighboring point where P is reaching Q, such that delta z is changing. So we can see here, that the along the real axis, the y coordinate is not changing. Therefore, our y is 0. Our z was equal to x plus iota y. Since y is 0, what we have, we get that z is equal to x. And a small change in delta z will be equal to now equal to delta x, and delta y will be 0. So making all these substitutions in this equation A, what we get? We get f dash z is limit delta x tending to 0, delta u by delta x plus iota delta v by delta x. So we get as the differential delta u by delta x plus iota del v by del x. Now similarly, if we choose our path along the imaginary axis, y-axis, where this is P is our fixed point and Q is the neighboring point where we are trying to reach, where there is a small increment in delta z. So now since the along the imaginary axis our x is 0, so our delta x will be 0. And since z is equal to x plus iota y, so x is 0 means that z will be equal to iota y, and delta z will be equal to iota delta y. So now we make all the substitutions in this A equation, So what we get our f dash z to be equal to limit delta y tending to 0 delta u plus iota delta y plus iota delta v upon iota delta y. So iota gets cancelled here, and here is an iota in the denominator, it becomes minus iota in the numerator. So we get minus iota times del u by del y plus del v by del y. Now we have already studied that if the differential is existing, then for any of the path follow, the value of the differentiable should be same. So now equating the equations of B and C equations, comparing the real and imaginary parts, we will have the equations that del u by del x plus iota del v by del x will be equal to minus iota del u by del y plus del v by del y. So equating the real and imaginary parts, we get del u by del x is del v by del y, and del u by del y is equal to minus of del v by del x. So these are the required equations, that del u by del x is equal to del v by del y, and del u by del y is equal to minus of del v by del x. And these are known as the CR equations or the Cauchy-Riemann equations. And for the differential to be existing, that the differential should be continuous functions or the differential should exist. So these were the necessary conditions which will prove that our function is analytic function. So now let's look at the sufficient condition for the function to be analytic function. So if we say that the function, what will be the sufficient condition? So for the sufficient condition, it is now seeing that the CR equations will be valid and the differentials are continuous functions. So if the CR equations are valid and the differentials are continuous functions of x and y, then we can calculate the differential of that function. So the sufficient condition is just the converse of the necessary condition. So there we prove that the function is differentiable, and we derive the CR equation, or we prove that the functions were continuous or the partial derivatives were existing. So now we are taking into the consideration that the CR equations are now satisfied, the continuations of the differentiables are maintained, but the condition we will find that it will be a differential function and the differential equation will be calculated. So the theorem states that the sufficient condition for the function to be analytic at all the points in R are that the del u by del x is equal to del v by del y, or del u by del y is equal to minus del v by del x, that is the CR equations are satisfied, and del u by del x, del v by del y, del u by del y, del v by del x are continuous functions of x and y in the region R. So let us look at the proof of the sufficient condition. So we say that the function f of z is a single valued function having del u by del x, del u by del y, del v by del x, and del v by del y at each point in the region R. And the CR equations are satisfied, which is del u by del x is del v by del y, and del u by del y is equal to minus of del v by del x. So we know by Taylor's theorem, we can expand our function. So our f of z plus delta z will be written as u, where u is a function of x and y. So it will be u of x plus delta x, y plus delta y plus iota v, where v is also a function of x and y. And with the small increments, we will have the function as x plus delta x, y plus delta y. Now, using the Taylor's theorem for the expansions of u and v, so we have applied the Taylor theorem, we get that u of x plus delta x, y plus delta y can be written as uxy plus del u by del x plus del u by del y into delta y plus higher order terms. And similarly for the v, we can write it as iota v xy plus del v by del x delta x plus del v by del y delta y. Now we shall club the equations, so we get uxy plus iota vxy. Collecting the terms of x variable, we have del u by del x into delta x plus iota del v by del x into delta x. Now collecting the terms of y, we have del u by del y into delta y plus iota del v by del y into delta y. So this u x y plus iota v of x y can is nothing but f of x y. So it is written as f of z. So we have written it as fz plus, and this is written as, we have now taking the delta x common, we get del u by del x plus iota del v by del x into delta x. Similarly, delta y is taken common, we get del u by del y plus iota del v by del y. Now, f of z plus delta z minus of fz is equal to del u by del x plus iota del v by del x plus into delta x plus del u by del y plus iota del v by del y into delta y. Now we have these CR equations. We can apply the CR equations in this equation. So what we get? We get here as del u by del x plus iota del v by del x into delta x plus iota is taken common. So we get here iota upon iota is minus del v by del x plus iota del u by del x into delta y. So upon rearrangement of the terms, what we get? We get this equation. So we get it as del u by del x plus iota del v by del x into delta x plus del u by del x plus iota del v by del x into iota delta y. So what we find? We find that this bracket term is common in both the delta x and iota delta y. So del u by del x plus iota del v by del x is taken common, and we get the term as delta x plus iota delta y. And this delta x plus iota delta y can be written as delta z. So this delta z is taken in the denominator of the right hand side. So we get here as limit delta z tending to 0 f of z plus delta z minus of fz upon delta z, which is equal to del u by del x plus iota del v by del x, because this was the term that was remaining in the right hand side. So for this quantity, which is the limit of fz plus delta z minus fz by delta z, this is nothing but the definition of the differential f dash z. So we get here that our f dash z is equal to del u by del x plus del v by del x. And if we use the CR equations and we convert all our x terms in terms of y, we get that our f dash z will be equal to del v by del y minus of iota del u by del y. So you can just simply substitute the CR equations here. You know that del u by del x is nothing but del v by del y, and del v by del x is nothing but minus del u by del y. So just substitute the CR equations, you get two equations for your f dash of z. So this is the sufficient condition which will prove that the function will be an analytic function. So in the necessary condition, what we had that if the function is analytic function, then the CR equations will be satisfied. But in the necessary, but in the sufficient condition, we have proving that the functions are satisfying the CR equations, and hence the function will be a derivable function, and the derivation or the differentiation of the function, that is f dash z, will be given by the equation that it is equal to del u by del x plus del v by del x. So using these equations, you are able to calculate the differential of the function also. Look at the example of the analytic functions. So we have a function which is given by x square y into y minus iota x upon x4 plus y square for z not equal to 0, and it is 0 for z equal to 0. We have to examine the nature of the function, whether it is a differential function, whether it is an analytic function or not. So we shall represent our function as f of z is u plus iota v. So we have written the function as x square y upon y minus iota x upon x4 plus y square. Now we shall resolve our function in real and imaginary parts. So the real part is u, which is equal to x square y cube upon x square x4 plus y square. And our v is the minus x cube y upon x4 plus y square. So now we will check all the functions, the differentials are existing or not. So now we are calculating del u by del x. So del u by del x means that the differential is with respect to x. So there is an increment in x, and let that increment be h, and h is tending to 0. So limit h tending to 0, u into u of 0 plus h u 0 minus u 0 0 upon h means there is an increment in x coordinate only, and no increment is in the y, because only differential is with respect to x. So now we substitute the value of u of 0 plus h0, means we have to take the value of u from this equation, where the x is now having the value of h and the y is taking the value of 0. So when we substitute x is equal to h and y equal to 0, what we get here? We get here as 0 upon h to the power 4. And u of 0, 0 means that x is also taking 0 and y is also taking 0 value. So 0 into 0 will be 0 and upon h. So we get a 0 answer as del u by del x. Similarly, if we now have the differential del u by del y, means we are differentiating with respect to y. So the increment is in the y coordinate and the x coordinate is having no increment. So now what we do, what we have here, we have that the x will assume the value to be 0 and y will assume a value to be k. So again, 0 into k will be 0. So it will be limit k tending to 0, 0 by k square minus 0 by k. So again, it is taking a value of 0. Similarly, we calculate for the differential of v with respect to x and y. So for del v by del x, again, the the increment is in the x. So it is 0 plus h, 0, and the denominator is having h. And for del v by del y, there is an increment in y. So it is written as 0 plus k, and the denominator is having k as the limit where k is tending to 0. So again, substitution for the first del v by del x, x will be h and y will be 0. But for del v by del y, x will take a value of 0 and y will take a value of k. And on these substitutions, again, we have a 0 answer. So we see here that all these differentials are a single-valued functions and they are existing, and even the CR equations are also satisfied, where the CR equations were del u by del x is equal to del v by del y and del u by del y is equal to minus del v by del x. So the CR equations are satisfied at the origin. So to prove the analyticity of the function, we have to check the differentiability also for different parts. So now let us check the differentiability at different path. So first path we consider is a straight line path where the equation is y is equal to mx. So when z is tending to 0, means that x will tend to 0 because the y is now represented in x. So upon substitutions, we have limit z tending to 0, f of z, when z is not equal to 0 is the equation that was given in the question. And f of z equal to 0, it was given to be 0 upon z, z is equal to x plus iota y. So I have taken minus iota common here. So from this, what I get here as minus iota x plus iota y, and I have an x plus iota y in the denominator. So this x plus iota y and x plus iota y gets cancelled. So since my y is equal to mx and since z is tending to 0 and my equation is converted into x, so my x tends to 0. So for y value, I substitute y is equal to mx. So I get the equation as minus iota mx upon m square plus x square, because here x square comes common in the numerator and denominator. So when I substitute the value of x tending to 0, so my equation tends to 0. So again, if I consider another path, that is the a parabolic path, y is equal to x square. So again, if my z is tending to 0, my x will also tend to 0. So now substituting the value of y is equal to x square, what I find that my x gets cancelled, it gets eliminated in my function, and I get a value of minus of iota by 2. So for different path, I have different values of the differential. For first path, I had 0 value, and for the y is equal to x square, I had a value of minus iota by 2. So I find that my function is not differentiable at z is equal to 0. Although the CR equations were satisfied, but the differentiability is not there. So we will say that the function is not analytic at the origin. So it is not an analytic function because we were checking or testing it at z is equal to 0. So this proves that the CR equations are the necessary conditions, but they are not the sufficient conditions to prove that the function is an analytic function. Now we shall consider another problem. In this problem, it is given that the function is an analytic function, and we have to find out these constants, that is C1 and C2 values. So we have to calculate this C1 and C2. So if our function is given to be an analytic function, it is mentioned in the question that the function is analytic function. So it means that the CR equations are satisfied. So we can see here from the question, we can resolve our real part and the imaginary part. So this part is the real part, and the term associated with iota is the imaginary part. So our u is x squared plus c1 y squared minus of 2xy, and v is c2 x squared plus y squared plus 2xy. The CR equations are del u by del x is equal to del v by del y, and del u by del y is equal to minus of del v by del x. So now we shall calculate del u by del x, del u by del y, del v by del x, and del v by del y. Since this is our u equation, so partial differentiating with respect to x means that we shall treat the y as constant. So on differentiating with respect to x, x squared leads to 2x. Since c1 y squared is only a constant term, so its differential will be 0. And on differentiating minus 2xy, we will get a minus 2y. So on differentiating u with respect to y, what we get here as the first term is a x term, so it will be treated as constant and its differential will be 0. So on differentiating c1 y squared, it will be 2c1y, and on differentiating minus 2xy, it will be minus 2x. So 2 again gets common and we get c1y minus of x. Now differentiating v with respect to x and y, and using the same property, we get here as 2c2x plus 2y. 2 gets common, we get c2x plus y. And on differentiating with respect to y, we get minus 2y plus 2x, which is equal to 2 times of x minus y. Now using the property that the CR equations are satisfied, so what we get here, that this del u by del x is equal to del v by del y. And we can see here that 2 of x minus y is same in both the equations. Similarly, for the other CR equation, del u by del y is equal to del v by del x, but with a negative sign. So we can write it as 2 times c1y minus x is minus 2 times c2x plus y. Now equating the coefficients of x and y in these two equations, we get here that our c1 will be equal to 1 and our c2 is equal to 1 also. So now substituting the value of c1 and c2, we get the function as f of z is x square plus y square minus 2xy plus iota x square minus y square plus 2xy. We are also required to find the differential of the function, that is f dash z. And we know that f dash z is del u by del x plus iota del v by del x. So we can substitute the value of del u by del x and del v by del x. And we know that del u by del x is nothing but 2x minus of 2y. So it is 2x minus 2y plus iota del v by del x is 2 times c2x plus y, where c2 is having a value of 1. So we get a value of 2 of x plus y. So on solving, we get it as 2 times 1 plus iota x plus iota y. And we can write for x plus iota y as z. So the value of f dash z is 2 1 plus iota z. Similarly, we can also use this equation, that is del v by del y minus iota del u by del y. And when we substitute its values, again, we get the same result, that is 2 times 1 plus iota z.